It was a sort of touch and go in the beginning when I started to go to their headquarters in San Bernardino. One day, this Sonny, who was one of the leaders, went off his bike and split his head open, and I helped him get it stitched up. I think we got to like each other. And then we did this run from San Bernardino to Bakersfield, and I was riding on the back of some of the bikes from time to time, shooting. We got rather close. They were very stylish and outrageous then, certainly. It took a great deal of style to affect that Hell's Angels look. And these were like full-time outlaws. They weren't weekend warriors that put an earring in and rode around. They wanted a nice story in Life magazine. Somehow, it was sold to them on the idea that this was going to improve their image. And they thought that was a very cool idea to get some pictures in Life magazine. The pictures ended up not running because the managing editor, George Hunt, thought they all looked like a smelly bunch of bastards, and so he just never even entertained the idea of using them. I spent a whole month talking with him and riding with him and going to the hospital with him and drinking with him and shooting pool with him and et cetera, et cetera. And I can't tell you what makes him tick. Remember the guy who asked Brando, says, "What are you rebelling against?" And Brando says, "What do you got?" I think that's about as deep as it gets. I find being around this sort of danger, exhilarating. But you never knew what was going to happen. And as I say, things could just turn or explode, or suddenly somebody gets an idea and boom, we're all gone, and that sort of thing. Every person with a camera was coming at Life magazine trying to get a job. And so, of course, this is something you threw everything you had into. This is not working for the post office. If you didn't really feel passionate about it, you wouldn't be there. And if you weren't really good, you wouldn't be there. Listen, if I just wanted to run my old man's business and marry a cheerleader, I could have stayed in Shelby, Nebraska.